The primary method of gender selection is in vitro fertilization with preimplantation genetic screening of the embryos. And when we do this, we can check the embryos for all 24 chromosomes and also know the gender of the embryo. And we could select just a single embryo of the desired gender and place that embryo back and have a very high pregnancy rate. So, you know, when we look at all 24 chromosomes with the PGD, we can tell for sure that the embryo is normal or not. And it turns out that when in vitro fertilization doesn't work, one of the primary reasons it doesn't work is because the embryos that are being transferred are not normal. So knowing that they're normal is very helpful. There are other PGD techniques, FISH being the chief among them, where you can look at the X and the Y chromosome, and they're very accurate for selecting gender. However, they do not do any good at all in terms of embryo screening. If we use the 24 chromosome technology, we can put back, you know, as I said, a single embryo. The gender, specificity with that technique in our hands has been 100%. So what we do with this technology is we give the female medicine so that she makes multiple eggs rather than the single egg that she makes in a normal cycle. And then we remove those eggs, and that's done through the vagina using a needle guided by ultrasound. The patient's asleep for this, so they don't feel anything or remember anything. Once we have the eggs out, we take them to the laboratory and we fertilize them with sperm. And at that point, the fertilized eggs are, we call them embryos. I don't know, technically they're actually pre-embryos, but we call them embryos. And so they start off at a single cell and they will divide to the 8-cell stage. And at that point, we can remove one of the cells and, using various technologies, analyze the cell to determine what the chromosomal content is of that cell, and then use that information to transfer just the embryos that are healthy and that are normal.